Spider-Man Far From Home is the latest movie to make Twitter espouse some gospel about the MCU Spidey being a hack and the Raimi trilogy being the holy grail of Spider-Man on film. I'm here to tell you, this movie, this Peter Parker, this villain, this MJ are the best there's ever been. This video is many things. It's a debunk, it's a review, it's a video essay. What I want to focus on is what's great about this movie. I don't want to focus on assaulting other people's opinions because they have a right to them. I want to focus on doing what this channel was made to do, which is to try and teach people what I think are important skills in filmmaking and what makes some of your favourite films so great. I'm going to start off with a short review of Far From Home. For me, Far From Home is the epitome of Spider-Man. People who criticised Homecoming used the fact that it didn't focus enough on the struggle between being Peter Parker and Spider-Man should be happy because this movie's central theme is Peter Parker's struggle between the responsibility he feels he has to protect people and defeat the Elementals and wanting to go back to his trip and be with MJ. Classic Spider-Man storytelling. And let me just say, Zendaya's MJ is fantastic and is one of the best characters in the movie. Far From Home has great action that's directed really strongly, as well as balancing a deep emotional heart, epic stakes, whilst also keeping some of the light-hearted tone of its predecessor. All the performances are great, there are a lot of great character moments, and like I said, Peter's struggle is classic Spider-Man storytelling. Another Spider-Man classic that returns in this film is Mysterio.
Hoping you'd ask.
Cheap parlor trick.
This Mysterio, I think, is the best, most entertaining, and most meaningful depiction of the character. As you probably guess, this is going to be the primary topic of this video. Many people have criticized this version of the tricky special effects artist for being yet another enemy created by Tony Stark for Spider-Man to deal with. To understand why this criticism is invalid, all you have to do is look at what I think is one of the most basic and important traits of a villain. Take any villain from any popular film, let's say Voldemort from Harry Potter. What is Voldemort's goal? His primary goal is to take over the magical world and kill anyone who isn't pure blood. On the other hand, what is Harry Potter's goal? Harry Potter believes that all wizards are equal and is best friends with a non-pure blood wizard. Voldemort's goals and beliefs are the antithesis of Harry Potter's beliefs. They are polar opposites. This alone isn't enough to make a villain a good one, but in the context of this film, it serves as a very important factor in the thematic structure of this movie, as well as making Mysterio an excellent villain. One of Peter Parker's main goals thematically in this movie is to step out of the shadow of his mentor Tony Stark and become his own hero. Quentin Beck represents the antithesis of that thematic goal. Mysterio is the physical embodiment of the legacy of Tony Stark, coming to hurt Peter and push him away from being a hero. Tony Stark is a very important character in Peter's life. He's also the biggest character in the MCU and a very prominent part of Homecoming, and so it makes perfect sense that he would have a massive impact on this film, especially after his very public death. After Tony dies, Peter needs to learn to step out of his shadow, and that's what he does throughout this film. Physically and metaphorically in his conflict with Mysterio. That is what makes this version of Mysterio such a fantastic villain. Not only do you understand his motivations, like him in some ways, and he's well written, he also is very important to the main character's journey throughout the film by being the obstacle for them to fight against. Going back to Harry Potter, Voldemort also represents that part of Voldemort that is quite literally inside of Harry, the part that would make him a good fit for Slytherin. The part he really wants to get rid of. Mysterio isn't just a villain to be fought and beaten and then the story ends. He's a key part of the movie's themes and tied closely with the main character. Spider-Man Far From Home does a lot of things really well, but what I think really stands out above the rest is its villain. Mysterio is expertly crafted into the narrative of the film so that he's not just an interchangeable villain that could be any cape-wearing flying monkey. He's a core part of the film's story and the main character's development. John Watts has to be commended on an excellent sequel to not only Homecoming, but Infinity War and Endgame as well. My name's Matthew, and this is For the Love of Film.
Thank you very much for watching my latest video. If you did enjoy, please subscribe and make sure you hit that notification bell to get information about when I upload new videos. Make sure to like this video and leave in the comments something you are interested in me talking about next. Thanks very much for watching.